Welcome to Allied Farm Honors. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about various analytical instrumentation techniques. Let us start our discussion with UV spectroscopy. UV spectroscopy is also called electronic spectroscopy. Why? Because when UV light is absorbed by a conjugated molecule, the electrons in an atom is going to be ejected. That's why electronic spectroscopy named came like that. And this is also called as fingerprint spectroscopy. The reason is UV spectroscopy is used for the identification of a molecule. That's why we are named as a fingerprinting spectroscopy. And don't confuse this fingerprint spectroscopy with fingerprint region in the IR spectroscopy. The sample cells used in the UV and visible light is different. For UV, you have to use the quartz and should not use the plastic or the glass, because plastic or the glass may absorb some light. So you will get wrong reports. That's why you have to use only quartz. And for the visible, you can use quartz, plastic and glass. And various light sources used in the UV spectroscopy are hydrogen lamp and tungsten lamp, only useful for the visible only, and a deuterium lamp for the UV light only. And xenon arc and mercury arc also used as a sources in the UV spectroscopy. And the condition is the transition light always less than the light. Reference standards in UV spectroscopy is potassium chromate K2Cr2O7. Angle between the source and detector is 180 degrees. It means you have to keep detector and source in a straight line. And the type of samples used in the UV spectroscopy is we have to use only liquid, and that liquid should be clear. Let us have a discussion on the detectors in the UV spectroscopy. Barrel air cells also used as a detectors, and photo cells also used as a detectors. Photovoltaic tube is also called zero bias mode detectors. And photo multiple tube having a derivatization in the HPLC. This technique are intended to enhance the detectability of the UV absorption. And the graph drawn for UV spectroscopy is, on x-axis you have to take concentration, and on y-axis you have to take percentage absorbance. And let us go for the IR spectroscopy. IR spectroscopy is also called vibrational spectroscopy. Why? Because here the bond is going to be vibrated when IR light is going to be used. And this is also called functional spectroscopy. Why? Because this, by using IR spectroscopy, we can determine the type of functional group present. And sample should having a dipole moment. Whatever the samples used in the IR, it should having a dipole moment. Very important for GPAT orientation. And the type of samples, we can use solids, liquids and gases, but they should have some dipole moment. And mercury are one of the source for the IR spectroscopy, and this is only used for the far IR spectroscopy. And this is, mercury arc is also called black bar source. Why? Because it will give it mostly 99% of the IR light is going to be emitted. That's why this is called black body source. And the tungsten filament is made up of closed nichrome wire, and you have to heat 1100 degrees centigrade. And glow bar source is a self starting source and filled by a sintered silicon carbide. It is 2020 bit. Nernst Glower is made up of oxides of zirconium, yttrium and erbium. And incandescent lamps are used for the near IR. And the standard used in the IR spectroscopy is polystyrene film. And sample techniques like pelletization, we have to apply 25,000 pressure, and we have to use KBR or the sodium chloride as a medium. And mulling paste is also used as a sampling technique. Here we have to use Nuzal. It is a purified liquid paraffin mineral oil, and sometimes Nuzal magma and the drug magma is same. That's why for alternative of the Nuzal, we have to use hexachlorobutadienes, perfluoroketosines and fluorobenzenes. And the other sampling techniques like solid sampling, liquid sampling and the gases sampling are going to be used. And these are some of the detectors. In thermal detector, they are made up of BASP, and bolometer is a containing platinum strip. And the principle used in the bolometer is Wheatstone bridge. Thermocoupling is the detector works on the basis of voltage induced at the junction of two different materials. Golo cell is change in expansion filled with xenon inert gas. And the another type is thermistor, that is mainly works on the basis of resistance detector. And let us have a discussion on the quantum detectors in IR. That is, quantum detectors are made up of lead tritium or the lead sulfide or germanium or indium antimonium. And eccentric detectors are photo detectors, and eccentric detectors are the photoconductive cells. And the another important point is the graph drawn in IR spectro is between the wave number and the percentage transmitter. In case of FTIR detectors, pyroelectric detectors are specially used in FTIR, and they are made up of triglycerin, sulfate, deuterated, and the crystal capacity of the pyroelectric detectors are current by voltage. If you calculate with this formula, you can the crystal capacity. Let us have a discussion on the NMR spectroscopy. Nuclear magnetic resonance, it is a photomagnetic resonance spectroscopy. Why? Because here we are going to determine the hydrogens, which is nothing but the photons. And RF absorption spectroscopy, here we are using radio waves, that's why they are also called RF absorption spectroscopy. And NMR spectroscopy is also called slow camera, very important for the GPAT. And the condition should have to follow is spin quantum number should not zero. If it is zero, the NMR spectrum won't work here. And the light sources is RF generator, that is oscillator. And 300 to 400 is the high responsive. And the sample cell tube rotates 30 rpm per second, nothing but rotation per second. And the length is 25 centimeters and width is 5 mm. Standard reference used in the NMR is silapentane, and the standard for the non-aqueous is 0.01 to 1% silane, nothing but TMS, tetramethyl silanes. Solvents used in the NMR are DMSO, it is an universal solvent, and aqueous solvent is 2,2 dimethyl, 2 silapentane and 5 sulfoate. This is for the aqueous solvents, and we can use the other solvents, but they are not important. And the NMR spectrum is only useful for the liquids. For the remaining, we have to dilute and convert into liquid, then we have to go for the analyze. FT NMR detector used in the NMR. NMR simming is the concept. Here the simming is a device, adjust the homogeneity of the magnetic field. It means it has to pass the magnetic field in a uniformly. And the Z, we have Z value, nothing but the sim. If the Z value is smaller, it is very important. If the Z value is greater, it is less important. Let us take example with Z1 and Z8. Among these two, Z1 is important. Let us have a discussion on the mass spectroscopy. Mass spectroscopy is not a spectrophotometer. Up to now, which we are discussing, they are all spectrophotometers. We are using light as a source. But in mass spectroscopy, we are not using light as a source. That's why it is not a spectrophotometer. And here we are using ionization techniques, and they are very important. But I am not here mentioned. You have to go through it. And the standard used in the mass spectroscopy is perfluorokerosene. And the detectors used in the mass spectroscopy is one of the important area which you have to focus. The detectors of mass spectroscopy are Faraday cup, quadrupole. Quadrupole is also called mass filter, and time of flight, FT ion cyclotron resonance, double focusing detector, magnetic field detector. These are the some of the mass spectroscopic detectors. And the graph we have to draw between the mass per charge and percentage absorbance in mass spectroscopy. Up to now we are discussing UV, IR, NMR and mass. These four are very important for the GPAT orientation, and very few times they will ask for other areas, but for your kind information I am giving this tabular column, which included analytical techniques, source, detectors and angle between the source and detector, detector materials and type of samples we are going to use, and what is the graph. Electron spin resonance, we have to use the source crystal oscillator, and the detectors are silicon crystals. Angle is not important, and detecting material is DPPH. Type of sample is only liquids, and the graph we have to draw intensity versus magnetic field. For the X-ray radiation, we have to take source as a colloid tube and which contains tungsten, and these are some of the detectors like photographic counter detectors, etc. I given here. And the angle between the source and detector is not important, and detecting materials like crystallar photon counters, and type of the samples like solids we have to use, and intensity versus wavelength we have to draw the graph. And flame photometry, it is a burner we have to use, and photo multiple tube we used as a detector, and sodium, potassium, lithium and magnesium are the detecting materials. In liquid form we have to take, and the graph we have to take related to emission intensity versus wave number. Atomic absorption spectroscopy, halo cathodes, lamp, electroless discharge lamp, like this we have to use, and photometric tubes we have to use. Sodium, potassium, calcium, magnesium we are going to be detected, and we can use solids, liquids and gases. Nephelometry and turbometry, white light, monochromatic radiation, tungsten lamp are going to be used as a sources, and photo multiple tube is a detector, and nephelometer we have to maintain 90 degrees, and turbometry we have to use 180 degrees. Suspensions also we can use, very important. Suspensions are going to be used by using Neflo or the turbometric detection. Absorbance versus volume we are going to be draw the graph. If you want in detail explanation of the spectroscopy, give a comment on which spectroscopy you want. I will prepare a video and I will upload on the YouTube.